In 2017, Elijah Crothers was a third-year apprentice studying to become a power line technician. But during a shift, in a rush to get back to work, he skipped the important step of putting on his safety gloves.
It didn't take long for me to make a wrong move, and that's when I made contact with the power line.
The impact of touching the live wire with his bare hands was immediate and severe. Both of his arms had to be amputated above the elbow. Elijah spent several weeks recovering in Sunnybrook's Ross Tilley Burn Center. Just a few months later, he received his first prosthetic arms. These bilateral prosthetic arms helped Elijah get back to the physical demands of life on his farm. But his movements were still limited.
I first started talking about this in about 2002.
Yeah.
To give you an idea of how long the development actually is.
Now, he's one of the first Canadian patients to use the latest advance in prosthetics, myoelectrics with pattern recognition technology.
With our traditional prosthetics, you will control the hand, and then you have to switch to control the wrist, then switch again to control the elbow. The amputee had to learn to do what the prosthesis is expecting. Now we can go the other way around. We teach the prosthesis to do what the amputee is expecting.
Traditional myoelectric prosthetics are controlled with just two electrode sites at the front and back of the arm. These new myoelectrics also run on a battery-powered motor, but have seven pairs of electrodes, as well as fingers and an opposable thumb, meaning different and more precise movements are now possible. Even though they are heavier, Elijah says controlling them is easier on his body.
Putting those on was unbelievable. Just the response that I got right away. And then having a hand on the end, just for the cosmetic factor is huge.
Even though the muscles have been interrupted by the amputation, the muscles are still firing. So what we're gonna use is multiple electrodes around that arm to give a different muscle signal.
Learning how to use them has been a process. But after months of practice and therapy, Elijah can now perform the most delicate of tasks, things he hasn't been able to do since his accident, like holding his girlfriend Felicia's hand while walking their dog Tilly, named in honor of Sunnybrook's Ross Tilley Burn Center. Glassford and his team are continuing to work with this new technology from Co-apt Engineering to see how it may help other amputees in the future and how it continues to help Elijah.
They will be extremely valuable to me, I think, more on as far as the inside work is concerned. But yeah, they're definitely super exciting.
With Sunnyview, I'm Monica Mattis.